Hope you're all doing well, and welcome to another episode of SEO and Digital Marketing Trends. Whether you're watching on YouTube or you're listening to a podcast on iTunes or any of the other platforms, I just want to welcome you and hope that the coronavirus situation is doing okay for you, and hopefully we get through all this pretty quick. You haven't seen a lot from me during the coronavirus because we've been concentrating on some other things. And this is definitely impacting businesses in many, many different ways. A few of the things we're going to get into today is we're going to discuss what's kind of happened with Google lately. There's been some changes in the last week or so regarding fluctuation in rankings and what I'm seeing with the testing that I do and what you may do going forward to kind of help your sites. And then also I want to get into a new tool that Google has launched to help you understand behavior more accurate times. I shared this on Facebook and a couple groups I'm in yesterday. I really, really, really like this tool because not only does it help you understand behaviors and what people are doing, but it's almost immediate keyword research. And if you do any sort of affiliate or lead generation, this is huge, huge, huge. I hope you take advantage of that. And I'll put some links in the descriptions, whether you're watching on YouTube again or listening on the podcast. You should have some links to the tool, and we're going to go through a little bit on here. Yes, you're seeing me. I wish I was at Freddy's. It's one of my favorite restaurants, great food, and also a great client. So let's switch over so that you can see my display now. And we're going to get into first kind of what I'm seeing with Google. And I'm going to do a little test while we're here because I want to see... I haven't tested how posts are impacting, so we're going to try with a couple of those. But what I am seeing is that some people are saying the algorithm affects sites that are thin on content. Some are saying it affects, backlinks. Honestly, what I've seen the biggest boosts with are sites that really don't have a lot of citations. So it's making me wonder if the citation sites have seen a decrease in value to where your quality backlinks are seeing an increase in value. That's just kind of my opinion, and I'm going off of pull up Ahrefs to look at a couple things. I want to show you, I'm seeing it more maps rather than search. Looking at my dummy site for pest control, which is on a sites.google platform, and I'm seeing quite a bit of change in here. And you say, well, it doesn't look like that much. Some of them, let's just look at the best scores. So you see some stuff right there where, for example, Wichita Pest Control ranks third. So it moved up 6 positions. But what I want to show you, let's take this down and go to just through April. And you see this number here on the bottom. So this is the daily average position. And like I said, this is a test site, and it does get leads though. So I'm looking through here, and it's showing daily average position for 111, 120, 120. And that's because it's looking for, some select keywords, and some of them aren't ranked. But then, boom, all of a sudden this week, we move up tremendously. So some keywords that weren't ranking in maps are ranking now, and some that were ranking are actually moving up quite a bit. So I'm going to track that a little more, and I'll let you know. I did see some similar things when I was looking through our agency one. Now, it definitely has, this is on Google, but we definitely saw some increases in areas. And I'll keep you updated on that. But for the test, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the dummy agency site, and I'm going to take the pest control site, and I'm just going to go back to some posts that we had before and basically recreate them, because I want to see if this is impacting at all. So what I'm doing is basically copying some posts that I had before, and then we're going to go back and search those keywords again and see if we've had any changes with it. Now I'm just adding my button, learn more, send them to the site. What is the URL? I gotta look, it's been a while. Business.site, that's right. Okay. Pasting that in the post. And publish. And then when I publish these like that, I go ahead and share to Twitter. Like if you follow me at all, you'll know. I send this through to Twitter real quick. Usually helps things get indexed a little more. And then, like I said, I want to go back and do the pest control one and do the same thing and see if that's impacting even more. You can see on the pest control here, let me scoot to the side. So look at the performance as of late. Search views have increased 20%. Map views increased 43%. This is in the last 28 days. So it's a dummy site, but it has been moving. So let's go look at the post for it. Copy one. I think I'd remember all these sites, but sounds a little tough. This one is actually on a sites.google.com. Let's see, what is that? And this one is definitely very thin on content. So if it was a thin content issue that was being punished, I would think I would see it more there. Definitely. Okay, so both of those are posted, and I'm going to tweet that one as well. And I'm going to give this another couple minutes, and then we'll go ahead and go check the rankings again. So what would I do going forward? I would concentrate less. This is me personally right now. I would concentrate less on the citation sites. Yes, you want citations, but you only need the quality ones. The top ones that have authority, and then the ones in your niche. I wouldn't go building 500 citations right now. I just don't know that that's going to help you that much. I will keep you updated much more on that. The other thing I would do is quality backlinks. I mean, those are always going to be important. So continue to reach out, get guest posts, get links that are contextual keywords back to your site. That's always going to be very important. So I am going to run some checks on those. We'll let those refresh and come back in a few minutes. And now what I want to do is show you what the new Think with Google tool. So thinkwithgoogle.com will get you there. And then what this is, it's about categories that people are searching on Google right now. So if I look through this, what they're showing me is the current category they have selected is swimming pools. And let me mess with my filters here real quick so that you guys can see a little better. There we go. Okay, so you should be seeing on swimming pools, the top growing queries in swimming pools are above ground pools, swimming pool, pool, in-text pool, inflatable pool, pools for sale, Walmart pool, summer waves pool. So I want to look at this in-text pool because that kind of interests me a little bit. And I'm going to go ahead and turn on my Ahrefs. I've never heard of an in-text pool, to be honest with you, but I'm not big into pools. I just want to see how competitive. Yeah, it's pretty competitive, but it's mostly big box type stuff. Target, Home Depot, Walmart, Amazon. But that doesn't mean there is an opportunity for you in this area. And I know someone I know real well, Jeff, who is a... Jeff Lenny is freaking awesome at affiliate marketing. He is probably not too excited that I'm showing you this right here, but also he understands. I know he likes this niche. So looking at reviews, there's some videos that rank up there. Wow. So outside of Amazon, the next site is actually poolcleanerlab.com, which has a DR of 11. This has 720 clicks or 720 searches per month. So someone could, in the top 10 is abovegroundpoolreviews.org with a DR of 3. So someone could really, really go rank for some of these keywords on in-text pools. There you go. You got a niche if you want to go after it. But that's what I like about this thing with Google. People are about this new tool that Google has is people are actually searching these things. One thing that I noticed earlier when I was looking at it, you know, you got sneeze guards. So sneeze guard for desk, sneeze guard for counter, acrylic sneeze guard, plexiglass barrier, hanging sneeze guard, and there's more keywords. You can continue to go down here. So if I'm building out content or an article on sneeze guards, man, look at all the keywords that I have to work with. And I think this showed when I was looking earlier, there were like 300 and something of these top trending categories. Let's see what they're up to. 308 stone fruits, mango, cherry, apricot, plum, nectarine, buffalo mango, green mango, Alfonso mango. Looks like mangoes are pretty popular for stone fruits, whatever that is. I'm assuming it's just a fake fruit, but I don't know. I think this will really, really help you identify some things that people are searching right now, especially during coronavirus. And, you know, you may be looking for a different way of generating revenues, different money streams, and affiliate, if you're not doing it, may be the right thing for you. I know I'm going to be spending some more time in here. If you follow Matt Diggity at all, I've talked to him about this just recently, and he is like hashtag pivot. He loves this tool and is suggesting it as well. Highly, highly suggest you look into this, start doing more research with it, building out more content, and hopefully you make some more money with it. So hopefully this has been good for you. We want to go back and check the SERP rankings real quick to see if the Google posts are having an immediate impact like they were before. Let's look at this one first. I see some quick changes, nothing that in the agency one. Let's go look at the one for pest control. Pest control had a little bit of change, but nothing major. It did move pest control Wichita from 16 to 3, so a change of 13. So I will say it can, your Google post can still impact immediately. Maybe not as drastic as what it was. Just because that was interesting right there, I am actually going to search this pest control maps again real quick since we've had about 5 minutes since we posted those. Update here in a minute. If you're using Bing, just a quick update on the Bing pages. I haven't done as much on it lately. I did notice that they fixed the Twitter part of it so that tweets were starting to come in there. I still can't go in and make changes to my actual profile or add new accounts yet, but let's see if we can promote tweets yet. Okay, so it is letting me promote tweets now when I couldn't do that before. Before it was only the YouTube videos. And they have updated the analytics within here, so I can now see what keywords it mostly targeted and how many clicks it got. I think when you choose categories for them, that you do get more clicks than if you just let them automatically do it. Let's go back one more time and see if this is updated. Okay, it has. So we did see a few more changes, nothing drastic. So I would continue to do your Google posts and maybe 3 times a day. And that's help, and it'll continue. If you stay consistent with it, it will continue to help you. But that's it for today. Let me know if you have any questions. Hope you guys like the content. Please share it. And look forward to seeing you guys soon.